Hey, what's happening? It's your boy Big K.R.I.T, third core representative, and one of my favorite things is the album called In My Lifetime by A-Ball and MJG. I mean, I've always been a fan of A-Ball and MJG, you know what I'm saying, since coming out hard, you know, and it was just one of those albums where it seemed like, you know, they got to the point where they knew exactly what they were doing as far as music. They weren't concerned with critics, and it was like, we're going to do what we wanted to do. You know, and they featured, and it won, and another thing that a lot of people know, it was produced by Organized Noise, which is another, like, a favorite, you know, group of producers that I, like, people that I actually, as far as inspired by, as far as my music is concerned. But A-Ball and MJG just went in as far as a record called Pay Dudes featuring CeeLo. It just had so much grit and so much soul, and it was coming from a place as far as an artist like me that's independent, underground, and rapping about the situations and the things that they went through as far as being artists and signing too early, doing shows for a C-note, as far as A-Ball said, and, you know, being in the hole in the wall clubs, but they it was all worth it at the end of the day, and paying their dues. And then you got a record like, you know, Nobody, and it's a record where they're talking about they can only be themselves as far as individuals. And I mean, it's just an amazing album, and I encourage anybody that loves soul, loves Southern hip hop, or just hip hop in general, to go pick up In My Lifetime, A-Ball and MJG, and you know, because it's hard to sum up what they did for me as far as being a Southern artist and making me proud, you know what I'm saying, to be such. And they rapped about their backyard, Orange Mound, Memphis, Tennessee, and didn't mind it. And I want to do the same thing. I want to tell people about Meridian, Mississippi, and I want to put them on the places they never heard before. And I think A-Ball and MJG did a great job of doing that as far as Southern hip-hop and being able to incorporate the blues and still being a little pimpish and flyish at the same time. You know what I'm saying? There's still records on it that's mad flyish and mad player, you know, and so I encourage everybody to listen to that too. And go listen to They Started This Shit, because that's a great record as well.